that is, you know, that's the size of the fish, an MS triple two. Rinse the triple two off, so you give it a rinse in lake water. Dry the fish off because you don't want water activating the semen. We also don't want urine and feces contaminating the semen, so the bulb pipette there, he's extracting the urine as much as we can.
There at first.
Okay. And then we'll wipe everything dry, put pressure on the fish and try and expel the semen. We harvest it into a test tube, and Donna takes the semen over and adds 6 mils of extender to 3 mils of semen, and then it's kept cool until this afternoon, and we'll use it on the feed.
Okay.
And well, the process for the females is similar. You anesthetize the fish, dry it, expel the eggs into a dry pan so they're not activated. You add the semen, get everything mixed up so that the sperm cells are close to the egg cells. And then you activate it with water, and that's when fertilization actually takes place.
Okay. So you mix multiple male sperm together.
Yeah. And then, yeah, in order to harvest 3 mils of semen, it usually takes a minimum of 2 males, and a lot of times it might take 5 or 6.
I think.
They're, like all the esophages, their volume of semen is fairly low. There's plenty of sperm cells in a drop, but it's just getting it to spread into the pan.
Right.
So we want to have enough that we can get sperm cells close to each egg and hopefully then get a high fertility rate.
Right.
Okay. So we're harvesting in excess of the number of sperm cells you would need for the number of eggs in the pan, but they don't all go to a separate egg. You want to get them close because they're going to go to the closest egg, or
right,
they're going to swim randomly at least.
Okay.
So the more you can get in there and mix it thoroughly before you activate the egg and the sperm, the better percentages you're going to get on fertilization.
Very good. Thank you.
You got it.
They settle down, don't they?
Thank you. These have been in here for some hours.
Longest 20 days.
Oh, really?
They started all the east on the 10th of April.
Is this a big one?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, go.
Not that long.
No.
Yeah. She hasn't been in here before.
So where's that one from?
East of the Bowling Lake.
That's the East Lake one?
That's at, I think, 49 when they initially weighed her when she first came in.
Right.
You got two of them.
Well, it's the same fish, so I'm going to do 1.5. Okay.
100,000? Maybe we'll stay at 5,000.
How many eggs would you estimate are in that pan?
Probably 100,000.
Put a tag in them. They'll put a little tiny electronic tag, kind of like if your dog ever has an electronic tag, so you know what it is. A little electronic tag so they can wave a wand over it. It shows them a number. And then they'll record it, A lot of these fish are already tagged, so they'll just record, yep, I caught it on this date, it was this big, weighed this much, and then they'll put it in their system. So every year that they catch them, we'll have information on how fast they grow, if they're moving to different lakes. All this information is very valuable.
You keep everything in the computer, huh?
Yeah, if you want to see the history of the fish, it was first put into the hatchery in 2005. And then 6 and 7, it was actually caught out of the east coast of Boji because the water was high and it must have gone over the spillway.
Okay.
So back in 2007, we put it in Spirit, and then we caught it in east coast of Boji again, so it must like going through the spillway, and now we're going to be putting it back into Spirit again.
They always try to keep them back in the lake of origin.
Yeah, of origin. Definitely with these muskies, since they don't naturally reproduce, we take care of the population, so if there's any movement, we try to pop them back over.
Sounds good. So how many years back do you have records?
Back in the late 90s, for sure.
Probably an old tag.
No, but it pushes up a little. No ID
taking the sperm, and they will put them into jars and save them for layers, so when they're fertilizing the eggs, it's a lot less hassle bringing the fish around and knocking them out and stuff. So it just helps out with the natural flow of taking all these fish in and then getting them out. And they don't want to keep these fish in here too long, because just like if I think you put you in a strange area, in a confined area for too long, you're probably going to get stressed out. Same thing with the fish. They don't want to be in here. They want to be out in the lake doing their normal thing. So we'll try to keep them in here as short time as possible. But while they're in here, after they get done stripping these fish, they will put a tag in them. They'll put a little tiny electronic tag, kind of like if your dog ever has an electronic tag, so you know what it is. A little electronic tag so they can wave a wand over it that shows them a number. And then they'll record it. A lot of these fish are already tagged, so they'll just record, yep, I caught it on this date. It was this big, weighed this much, and then they'll put it in their system. So every year that they catch them, we'll have information on how fast they grow, if they're moving to different lakes. All this information is very valuable to know how the fish are doing in our lakes here. So most of these bigger ones are already tagged. If they're not tagged, they will be tagged, and they will be sent back to the lake where they're caught. Pretty cool, huh? Anybody have any questions? If you look behind you, you can see all of the those are all walleye eggs. So there's an awful lot of them. And then over here, on that, those two jars over there, those are the muskie eggs that they've already taken care of. They can actually warm up the eggs to make the patch grow faster, which I think is pretty cool. So they can actually add heat to the water and warm them up and make them hatch a lot faster. Over here, these are the baby northerns. Northerns grow very, very fast. And they're keeping them in here to get them a little bit bigger. These guys, northerns, release their eggs right after the ice goes out on the lake. So these are the very first fish that spawn. And these guys, you can see them. It's kind of neat because you can see their tummies. You see they look like a grain of rice, but they have that bump. That's their stomachs. full of feed, and the feed that they have is just basically fish food, just a powder, and they'll eat that powder until they get a little bit bigger, and then they'll start eating smaller fish and minnows. But they'll keep them in the fish hatchery for quite a while until they get a little bit bigger, and then they'll release them, because the bigger the fish that you release, the better chances it's going to have to survive. But also here, they also have to account for, it's going to cost a lot more for that fish to grow in here than it is just to release them. Because all these fish cost money to grow. Yep. And while they're in here, they do different things. They'll feed them. You see these jars that are up by the water? They'll actually give them medicines to keep them free of parasites and other diseases. And they'll be in here for quite a while. Once they start getting bigger, they'll have to expand them up to other tanks so they don't crowd each other out, they don't need each other. But it's definitely a process. There's always got to be someone that is knowing what's going on here 24 hours a day. They have beepers. Because what happens if the power went out and the water stopped flowing? They would have a fish hatchery full of dead fish. So there's always somebody on call just in case the power goes out. They run here real fast, turn on the backup power, and then make sure everything's going right. Just in case something were to happen. They actually have emergency oxygen. I don't know if you guys are wondering what these things are on the floor. This is emergency oxygen, just in case the power were to go out. They'll throw these in the tanks, and it'll put oxygen in the water. Pretty cool, huh? So you have to be very careful when you're taking care of animals like this. Otherwise, you'll lose all of the fish that you worked so hard. Great. Anybody have any other questions? Nope, no questions? I'm just that good at explaining everything, right?
Well, what is it?
That's just because they pour it. Yeah, that's a good question. You think they know how many eggs they have over there? Oh yeah, there's a good estimate. They have to figure out how much eggs they have. They'll also do viability studies to figure out how many eggs will survive. So they'll actually take the eggs out. They'll take 20 of them, figure out which ones are alive, which ones are dead, and that gives you a percentage on how many will survive, they think. So they know exactly how many eggs are in there. They know the percentages of viability, how many will survive. They even know how many are in here. We'll have to do counts every day. Yep. So it's a lot of math is involved when you're doing stuff like this, especially in science. It's not an exact count, but they have a pretty good idea.